morning students, welcome to Divya Digital Classes. Today I would like to explain the change of state in matter. Previous class we already discussed about what is matter and what are the examples of matter, what matter consists of, and also what are the states involved in a matter. In mainly the three states involved in matter around the surface of the earth, the three are solids, liquids and gases. Another three states involved in matter, they are explained. They are plasma state, Bose-Einstein state, at the same time fermionic condensate state. The last three are not important to your studies. For the studies, it will help to all of. Now we have to discuss the change of state in matter. When the matter of state can be changed, that is the main thing of this topic. First of all, we learn about temperature and pressure. Any state in matter, not only in single state, in permanent. The state matter of state can be changes depending upon the temperature or pressure. We have to apply the some heat energy of temperature on any matter like solids, liquids, gases. That type of solid can be converting into another type of state. Which type of state can be converting here? We are explained here. The change of state can be converting into a few many topics. They are explaining few words here learning. First one is melting, second one is freezing or fusion, third one is vaporization or boiling, and fourth one is condensation, and fifth one is sublimation, and last one is solidification. We have briefly discuss about each one. First of all, what is melting? We will go to melting. First, what is the meaning of change of state? That is the definition right here. What is change of state? The change of a substance from one physical state to another physical state, it is called as change of state. A small example, like a water cubes are taken in a bowl and then temperature is added to that bowl. Then the solid state can be converting into a liquid state. That means one type of physical state can be converting into another physical state. When it is possible, the energy is applied to that body, that state. That is, first one is melting. What is the meaning of melting? The definition of melting was the changes from solid state to liquid state on heating at a constant temperature. That is called melting. What is the meaning of melt? Solid state can be converting into liquid state. What are the examples of melting here? So many examples. First one is ice cubes to water. I already told, ice cubes can be converted into water when it is possible some energy is applied on that body, that is nothing but heat or temperature. And second one is burning of candle. We have to burn the candle. The candle is a solid state, then it was in converting into liquid state. And burning of butter, we already know that. What is the meaning of burning of butter? We heat the butter, then it is a solid state to converting into liquid state. So many examples of this melting. Few examples are written here. That is ice cubes of water and burning of candle, at the same time burning of butter. And briefly explain. And next one is freezing or fusion. This is also a reversible process of melting. What is that? Reversible process of melting. The changes from liquid state to solid state on cooling. Here heating on melting, but this case freezing or fusion in cooling. We are already know that in our homes water is put in into ice cube trays kept in a refrigerator. After that we have to take a liquid like water. Then after few hours the water is can be converting into ice cube, that means a solid state. So liquid state can be converting into solid state. Here rejection of heat takes place. In melting, absorption of heat takes place. That means ice cubes can be converting into water. That means liquid. But here freezing or fusion, rejection of heat can be takes place. That means the water can be converting into ice cubes at our refrigerators. Small example. Ice cube tray kept inside the refrigerator. We will take water and then we will take the ice cubes. At the same time, formation of snow. So cold countries are winter season. We are also known that formation of snow. Snow is also a liquid state to containing a water state. That means solid state. At the same time, melted candle wax. Already we give the example burning of butter or burning of candle. Here melted candle wax. We have to burn the candle. The liquids can be converting into down the earth on the floor. After a few seconds or few minutes, the liquid can be converting into solid. That is the best example of melted candle wax. Okay students, here we have an example for the both melting and freezing. First example was, we have to take a ice cubes in a one beaker. At the same time, we have to add the heat. That means energy. The energy supplied to the ice cube beaker, then the ice cubes can be converting into liquid. Ice cube means solid. Solid state ice cubes can be converting into liquid. What is the meaning of melting? The change of solid state to liquid state on heating at a constant temperature is called melting. Already you told that. Okay, this is the best example. Here the ice cubes absorb the heat. That means observation of heat can be converting solid to liquid. In the phase of reverse here, then the liquids can be converting into solid. Here we are not adding the heat, but here we reject the heat. That means cooling. In this environment of homes like a refrigerator, already you know the small example, that is ice cube tray. The liquid put into the fridge, that means the liquid and the water can be converting into ice cubes. That means liquid state can be converting into solid state. Here the rejection of heat takes place. That means we have another two points can be such here. That means melting point at the same time freezing point. What is the meaning of melting point and what is the meaning of freezing point? First of all, at a particular temperature, the solid can be converting into liquid or liquid can be converting into solid. That particular temperature is called melting point of that substance. That substance means the solid can be converting into liquid at 0 degrees centigrade of ice. Therefore, the 0 degrees Celsius of ice is called as melting point of ice or solid. At the same time, the liquid also, it is having any room temperature like 27, 28, 29. At particular thermal equilibrium, the liquid can be converting into solid. It is 27 and decreasing. 27, 10, 8, 3, 1, 0. The liquid 0 degrees at particular temperature, it will be converting into ice. That particular temperature is called freezing point. The freezing point of water is 0 degrees centigrade. This is called freezing point, and 0 degrees Celsius of ice is called melting point. Okay students, we we have to go further topic, that means vaporization or boiling. Vaporization or boiling. What are the definition of vaporization or boiling? First of all, already know that two definitions, that is melting and freezing, same like this vaporization. The change of liquid state can be converting into gas states on heating at constant temperature, that means absorption of heat, is called as boiling or vaporization. Okay, what are the examples of vaporization? Water can be heated, then water can be converting into steam. That means that is nothing but liquid can be heated, that means water can be heated, then it will be converting into steam, that means vapor. This is the best example of vaporization or boiling. A small example here. This is water. We have to apply the heat, then this is converting into gas, that means vapor. After some temperature, we have to add the liquid. This is the best example for vaporization or boiling. This is nothing but water to steam. Okay, after that we have to explain the another definition, condensation. What is the meaning of condensation? What is condensation? This is the reversible process of the vaporization or boiling. Same like this, the change of gas state can be converting into liquid state by cooling is called as condensation. Cooling means rejection of heat. It is also known as condensation or liquefaction. What are the examples of condensation? We know dew forming on grass in the early morning. In winter season, we have to see that dew forming on the grasses, green grass, in the early morning. At the same time, in hot summer, we take a cool drink. The glass surroundings, we have small water waterlets or water bubbles on the surface of the glass. That means droplets on can or a water bottle, like glass or water bottle or everything. At the same time, foggy mirrors or car mirrors in winter season, car mirrors, bus mirrors, at the same time, or bathrooms, fog mirrors. At the same time, we have to observe the small droplets on the mirror. And clouds. Clouds are passed away on the surface of the earth. That means clouds is nothing but gases. That gases can be converting into raining, that means liquid. So clouds are also best example for condensation. What is the meaning of condensation? Gas state can be converting into liquid state. So clouds are also best example for the condensation state. Okay students, the best example for the vaporization and condensation, it was looked at here. We have some heat energy can be adding to the liquid beaker, the liquid inside a beaker, then the liquid smally boil. That means liquid can be converting into gas state. Gas state means steam. What is the meaning of boiling or vaporization? The liquid state can be converting into gas state. That is called boiling or vaporization. This phenomena absorption of heat can be takes place in this vaporization or boiling. That means liquid can be converting into steam. Otherwise, that reversible process of this vaporization, the steam can be kept in a cool like a refrigerator, then steam can be converting into the liquid. Here two important things are available here. That means first one is boiling point and second one is condensation point. First one is boiling point, another one is condensation point. Here, like melting point and freezing point, 0 degree centigrade of ice can be converting into water, At the same time, 0 degree centigrade of water can be converting into ice, that means solid. At the same time, the liquid, 100 degree centigrade of water, this is the boiling point. That means, you know that, what is the boiling point of water? Water, 100 degree centigrade. Here, 100 degree centigrade of heat, we can apply to the liquid. Then, liquid state of water can be converting into steam. At that particular temperature is called boiling point of that state. That state means in liquid state here. That liquid state having the, what are the boiling point here? That means 100 degrees Celsius of water is the boiling point of water. At the same time, 100 degrees Celsius of steam can be converting into, that means 50 degrees, 60 degrees, 70 degrees. This is not can be converting into liquid. We have to apply the 100 degrees Celsius of steam, that 100 degrees Celsius of steam can be converting into cool, not a heat here, that is reduction of heat. Downwards to the temperature, reduction of heat can be takes place, then 100 degrees centigrade of steam can be converting into liquid. That 100 degrees centigrade Celsius of steam here called as condensation point, that is the peak point of temperature, that is condensation point, that is 100 degrees Celsius is the steam point of condensation point of the steam. Okay, we have to go further definition of sublimation. What is sublimation? It is a direct process of solid state can be converting into gas state with eliminating of liquid state. This type of process is called sublimation. That means a change of solid state directly to the gas state on heating at constant temperature, neglecting the liquid state, is called as sublimation. What are the examples? We know the best example of sublimation only once, that is dry ice. We have to take a beaker and it is filled with water. Then we have to take a small piece of dry ice. This is poured into the liquid. Then the solid can be directly converted into fog. That means vapor. Like this. That is dry ice is the best example of sublimation. That means liquid solid state can be directly converting into gas state with eliminating of liquid state. So many examples to the sublimation. Another example was ammonium chloride also. At the same time, iodine. These three are best examples of sublimation. Okay, right? After that, we have to discuss another definition of solidification. What is that? Solidification is the exactly reversible process of the sublimation. Here, solid can be converting into gas. At the same time, in solidification, gas state can be converting into directly to the solid and neglecting the liquid state. This type of state is called solidification. The definition is the change of gas state to the solid state without involving the liquid state is called as solidification. What are the examples of solidification? Same examples here. That is dry ice. It is kept in a cool, the vapor is can be converting into directly solid. At the same time, ammonium chloride, iodine. These two are kept in a cool place like refrigerator. Then this vapor state can be converting into solid state. These all are best examples of solidification. Okay, students. We conclude the single diagram in this lesson. We told the all topics in a single diagram. That means already we tell about melting, boiling, freezing, condensation, sublimation and solidification. These all are in a single diagram. That means the solid ice can be converting into liquid. That means solid state can be converting into liquid state. This type of process is called as melting. First one is completed. After that, the liquid state can be converting into solid state. This type of process is called as freezing. Best example was ice is can be converting into water, and freezing of best example are liquid is can be converting into ice cubes in our refrigerators. Okay, after that the liquid state can be converting into gas state on heating applied to the liquid. This type of process is called as boiling. The best example is water can be converting into steam on heating. That means liquid state can be converting into gas state. At the same time, the gas kept in a cool place like a refrigerator, then the steam is can be converting into liquid like water. This type of process is called as condensation. So many examples they are a fog mirror, clouds, and waterlets on a water bottle and glass like this. Okay, and finally another two definitions of sublimation at the same time solidification. In this process the liquid state is eliminated. That means the solid state can be directly converting into gas state. That is called as sublimation. Best examples are dry ice, iodine, ammonium chloride. Quietly opposite to the this process, that is the gas state is kept in the cool place like a refrigerator, then the steam is can be converting into solid. Here also liquid also eliminating, then the gas state can be converting into solid state is also called as solidification. Okay students, I hope to all the students understood. Thank you.